Somebody say clean up. Every person under 25 say clean up. There you go. Clean up your language. Clean it up. That's one thing, the reason America has gone down. We quit respecting people. I started to say older people, but you ought to respect people. It's a certain way to speak. If you got to be nasty mouth, get on down the hill with the dogs. He got a nasty mouth. He can't understand what you say, and you can't understand what he said. You cuss. You talk nasty talk. And the dog be out there. You don't know what he's talking about. Just get your dog and go talk nasty to him. Clean up your language. Young men my age would rather have been beat in public than for grandma to hear them using bad language. Huh? And now I'm a preacher. I go in and 18 and 19 year olds know I'm a preacher. They be just standing there buying their beer and just a cussing. And I be saying, son, you're not disrespecting me. You disrespecting that mama. Who didn't teach you no manners? You ain't showing me up because I didn't raise you. Ain't the Lord all right? Amen. Clean up your appearance. Go to the house of God like you're going to the house of God. You don't have to have a towel, but at least you can be clean. You can look like somebody. Clean up your house. So when the preacher comes, you don't be running and people can hear you bumping and throwing stuff. People always think that they the only one can hear themselves. I'll be there in a minute. They know what you're doing. They know better than look under your couch. Rectify your own personality first. And then I just threw this in. Register to vote and then vote. I figured Deacon Cooks would like that. Be the church regular. And guess what? Most of y'all today were on
time.
Same man over here. Amen. There you go. There you go. Because some of y'all who used to always be late this morning, you were on
time.
Amen. I'm just playing with y'all. I'm sorry. I ain't going back up that boat and pick it up. I know when you were born. I do not pick that rap, but I know when he was born. Then God will bless you with a temperament. Somebody said temperament. And a testimony.
Yeah.
Ask God for the temperament of a Christian and the testimony of a Christian. Ain't the Lord all right?
Amen.
Then you will be a living example. Let God know. That you appreciate it. Huh? Let folks know that you believe us of God. Every day I got some young men in this church I can hug. They don't ever come down around front, but they drop in the church. They come to church. They come to church. May not come every Sunday, but they come to church.
Yes,
and if you're going to be with them, you got to go to church. God will bless you with a temperament and a testimony for him. You'll be a living example. Don't get mixed up in this world's mess. Look at verse 6. Give not that which is holy unto dogs. Neither cast your pearls before swine. In other words, when God clean you up, go to clean places. Don't be talking holy stuff to folks that you know don't believe in God. Ain't the Lord all right? Offer other folks salvation. If they refuse it, shake the dog. Praise the Lord, all right? Amen. Don't plead, don't beg nobody to go to hell. Talking about when I'm with you, I sure want you to go to heaven. Because I love you so much down here that I want to love you in heaven. Well, you're going against the Bible. Because the Bible said it ain't going to be no coating and it ain't going to be no marrying up in heaven. Amen. If a person get on your nerves so bad till you think he's going to hell, you need to leave him alone. Because guess what? If he on his way to hell, he'll make your life so miserable till you do things that'll get your soul in trouble. I didn't know how to cuss till I married Bobo. See, you should have left Bobo alone a long time ago. Don't plead with nobody. Don't beg with nobody. Don't have barbershop Bible debates. Amen. Ain't the Lord all right? Amen. Ask God for his testimony. Look down at verses 7, 8, 9. I'm going to let y'all go. Ask. Huh? Ask and it shall be what? Given unto you. You want a change in your life? Ask. How many times your friend or your significant other ever call your house and say, what you doing? And you say, I was praying. Be praying sometimes.
Amen.
Ask God to guide you. Ask. 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 And God will give it to you. You want to be sober? Ask. Ask. God doesn't send you to hell because you get caught up in a fault. No. Ask God to help you be sober. First thing, if you had started off by saying the blessing over your butt wise, amen. Back in the day, I used to think that you couldn't eat fish on Friday night without some suds to wash it down. And guess what? I would pray over every meal except the Budweiser meal. I felt so guilty when the Budweiser said that, Brother Henderson. But if you pray over the Budweiser, guess what? After a while, you won't want it. Lord, make us humble, truthful, and thankful for the Budweiser we couldn't drink. By the time you get through praying over it, you won't want it. Your problem is you don't say the blessing over all the stuff you take in. Ain't the Lord all right? Boy, ain't y'all glad y'all came? Ain't y'all Stevens is glad y'all came today? The bubble was hot today. Now, they ain't gonna call me nothing but Bubba. Now, they call me the real man Chase, but I know they ain't gonna call me nothing but down that side of that road but Bubba. Ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall what?
Find.
Knock and it shall be what?
Open.
For everyone. Everyone that ask it, receive it. Good God Almighty. And if you ask, you say, well, I've been praying and nothing happened. Have to keep on praying. If you ask and the Spirit is willing and it's in God's will, God will give it to you. Every time. I'm a living testimony. He that seeketh findeth, and to him that knocketh, it shall be what? And if you knock on it long enough and the door doesn't come on, take your foot and kick it down. There's something on the other side that God would have for you. Ask for God, ask for his gifts, his testimonies, his deliverance, his delivering gifts. Include love agape, and you should want God's love even over your love in other phases of your life. Eros, you ought to pray over Eros. Say, Lord, I'm in love with that woman, make sure she's the right one. Lord, I'm in love with that man, make sure he's the right one. Pray over your love. Another gift is patience. Patience that have not, for those that have not overcome. Some of us church folks forget where God brought us from. We forget that we used to have drinking problems. We forget that we used to have gambling problems. We forget that we used to rather play bingo than to go to choir practice. We forget that we used to do things that were not pleasing in the sight of God. And as soon as somebody else sinned, we're ready to kick them out of the church and not speak to them no more. Then pray for peace. Somebody say peace. Peace that passes all of us. Last but not least, pray for salvation. Yes. Save now and saved in heaven. Look at the 12th verse, and that's the end. Therefore, all things whatsoever you would that men should do unto you, do even unto them. That's the golden what? Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. You don't never call me. Well, why don't you call them? Huh? You used to come by my house. Well, why don't you go by their house? Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Then God will be pleased. For he died for us. He arose for us. He ascended to heaven for us. He sent the Holy Spirit for us. Holding his holy judgment for us. For God is the righteous judge. Through Jesus Christ. Yes. Somebody say, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Give God a hand clap of praise. That's how the week. Give God a hand clap of praise. Amen. Just as I am.